He has a great deal of working experience as a nutritionist in feed industry. For the topic, broiler chicken from hatch to kitchen, I consider it a great honor to welcome on dice Executive Vice President, WPSA Pakistan Grand Southern Zone and nutritionist K1 Feeds, Dr. Shahid Wahid, to present his valuable expertise regarding this topic.
The topic of the presentation is broiler chicken from hatch to kitchen. So, a hatchery is an environment actually where birds, reptiles, anything, any egg can be hatched. Reptiles do hatch their eggs in the same with the conditions of humidity, with the condition of temperature. And that condition is actually provided in the hatchery. This baby chick is having mother, having father. It is not coming from any sort of cloning or anything else. So this baby chick, when it comes from the hatchery, its weight is 40 grams almost. But a baby chick, if it is broiler in genetics, it's having the genetics of a broiler, it becomes 2 kg weight in after 35 days almost, and having 3.2 somewhat lesser per feed. But if that broiler male or female chicken are raised, and the female chicken, they lay less eggs, 60 to 100 eggs in 365 days. In a whole year, they lay very less eggs, but they can produce much meat, fast growth. On the other hand, if you have the same, almost same feeding standard for the layers, white layer, which is commercial layer, or colored layer, it becomes 1 kg weight after eating 4 to 5 kg feed in 100 days. It cannot exceed the weight, accelerate the weight within a few times. So this is basically the difference of the genetic. Let us understand why it happens. So main factors of broiler fast growth are the genetics, number one, as I described. Number two is the nutrition. And number three is the management. So broiler of the today, or the meat bird of the today, is not like it was happening from the ancient times. In 1920, when the research on the poultry birds started, the chicken had 1 kg weight in 120 days. In 1940, 1.4 kg in 85 days. In 1960, the weight increased 1.6, but the days reduced 70. Eventually, in 2015, the research on the selection side of the broilers, the age of 35 days broiler chicken usually have 2 to 2.5 kg weight. So it's a historic perspective when the selection of different single lines, I think the people related to the genetics may understand well, that the genetic selection within the same line increases the number of genetic traits to be transmitted in the next generation. So these things happening again and again over years and years, it's not the story of 1, 2, 3 days or even 1 year or 2 years. And poultry is a short generation animal, so that's why it happened very early. As per the genetic science, it took almost 50 years to develop a tree like that. So ultimately we get grandparents, and that GP results into the parents, and that parents they produce a fertile egg. That fertile egg is hatched in the hatchery and the chick comes. Unfertile egg is never hatching in the hatchery, and hatchery cannot produce chick within the 10 days. So there are not much myths, but this is 100% natural, only the conditions in the hatchery are provided. So chicken is genetically improved through selection. It's not genetically modified. I mean, it's non-GMO, and no genetic engineering or cloning is there. So it's like corn yield. It was 1 ton per acre in Pakistan, and it is now 5 tons per acre due to the better genetics of the corn. Similarly, you see the Sahiwal local bull. It becomes 130 kg in 1 year, but the typical selected genetic selection of the Belgian bull usually gains more than 600 weight within 1 year. And similar case in the locally, you see the dairy goats, they are having less weight, and some goats are having of the same age, the goats having 70 and 30. This is a weight difference, and that difference is due to the genetics, Virasat ki wajah se. And similar is the in the lactation, our cows usually give 14 liters per annum, that is lactation average per lactation year, and a Friesian cow, that's average is 43 liters. The difference is only the genetics. Even in human, it's a not much variation. Average weight of East Timor, the separated province of and now the country from Indonesia, the weight is 53.9 kg average, and height is 4 feet 11 inches. But in Netherlands, it's almost 64% more weight. Same human, same diet patterns and things like that, but genetics does matter. And this is called the genetics. That's the basic key why broiler have very fast growth and very rapid weight gain. The second important thing is management. The management, poultry farm management is combination of scientific knowledge and accurate steps at proper time. Farm management is in a scientific way is practiced. Downtime between flocks, pre-replacement, brooding management, litter management, water management, feed management, and environmental control management is very much important in poultry raising. And look, last but not the least, the health management. So these are some factors like age, weight, birth region, maternal factors, feed, sex, I mean the male usually grow more than the female. Housing conditions, hygiene, that's much more important, biosecurity to avoid diseases. So these are some of the factors. So basic principles of the farming, for the scientific farming are housing, usually open or environmental control, but the conditions of its selection, its direction, its sun and rain protection, flood protection is very much important. Disinfection of the farms when the birds are not there, that is vital importance. Surface cleaners, fumigation sometimes done, mostly breeders and some other specialized aspects. Biosecurity at farm level is very much important, and to know the biosecurity, it's very easy now after COVID times, that every one person should be separated from the other. And at the farm level, any living thing must not be entering in the farm except the birds and the attendants. And the water quality is very much important. It's bird usually if have 100 grams feed intake, the water intake is somehow 200, 300, in some cases more than that in summer season. So water quality is the most important factor at the farm level. Feeding routines, equipments, and strategy is important. Medication in water regarding the organic acids, electrolytes, vitamins, minerals. Vitamin C is given from the plants. Very important is the ventilation, carbon dioxide, oxygen flow, humidity, and these all parameters are atomized now in the control houses. So chicken science and research is similarly important like other animal studies and human studies, and needs veterinarians, nutritionists, microbiologists, pathologists, physiologists, and poultry scientists, not important in meat and food science experts. Internationally, this is very much important. So farms are grounds of genetic and nutritional expressions resulting in feed. Now let's see some bit about the basic and important number three part, that is the nutrition of feeding. Broiler feeds. Digestive system is very simple, but it's very efficient. Chicken digestive system is, chicken is omnivores and monogastric like human. It has less taste buds as compared to human and other animals also. It has poor sense of smell, but better than the organoleptic other mayors. So it can be used as the research studies and feeding experiments. It can be used as a laboratory bird. So a feed industry, a feed manufacturing is basically designed on identifying nutrient requirements of the bird and available ingredients in the country are analyzed in the laboratories. Then they are formulated on very high technology softwares, and that after that international standards, milling machinery and process flow systems are available with automated system and feed is manufactured. Quality assurance laboratory, that is the vital part, I think the most important part of the feed mix. And it's a general, usually the question in the mind of people, what ingredients are used in the poultry diet? So they are the cereals, more than 50 to 60% of the cereals, corn, wheat, rice, broken salt, and whatsoever available, it will be used. The second most important, and that is the vital ingredient from protein point of view, soybean meal, that is used minimum 20%. It may be 25-30%. Some wheat bran, rice polish, that is used 5%, canola meal 5%, sunflower, guar meal, corn, gluten meal, and fish meal. Rapeseed meal, these are availability and their constituent, usually they constitute 10% roughly of the feed formulation. And limestone, marble, chips are the calcium carbonate and DCB compromise 1%. Similarly, canola, sunflower, or other oils are 1%. Amino acids, lysine, methionine, thumine, arginine, 1%. Vitamin minerals, no doubt, for the part of the recipe. Feed mill laboratories are very much scientific. They proceed their research, and any ingredient is analyzed for moisture, proof protein, fats, and carbohydrates, minerals. In the laboratories, amino acid analyzer, fatty acid, gross energy determined, and heavy metals, vitamins, and pathogens, microbial checks, and toxins, specifically the mycotoxin control programs are there. So all the instruments like pan photometer, spectrophotometer, HPLC, and ELISA, and calorimeter, we are in the industry are much familiar with all these programs, and they are actually running instruments in the fields. So after ingredient analysis on the local laboratory, even we go for outside the, like PCSAR here in Pakistan, STS Micro Lab, sometimes Intertech, and HEJ are other local sources. We also visit the international laboratories like Pacific Lab, Singapore, Robotic Laboratories, and APCO Lab, France. Feed mill operations are, I've just concluded, feed mill operations are first of all, receiving of the ingredients, quality checking in the laboratory, storage in the godowns or silos, then the grinding, batching, then mixing, conditioning or pelleting, after that cooling, seeding and grading, and at the last packing of the feed in the bags. So grinding instruments usually in the history, rural bodies were very much familiar, but now modern grinders are available. And mixing, the mixing paddle mixers and ribbon mixers both are available. And for conditioning, that's the typical term. It's basically addition of the steam into the meals, into the mixed meal, into the mixed feed. Steam is added to check, reduce the pathogen, especially salmonella and some other, which are very much sensitive to the meat. The temperature of the meal and steam usually goes up to 85 to 90 degrees sometimes. The steam temperature is well above 120 degrees Celsius. So pelleting is the finished product. Feed is coming in the pellets, and that is reduced up to the size of the birds which consume. So research on the broiler feeds, on ingredients, nutrients, growth rate, and health. We have the research stations, R&D stations, near to our factories, near to our facilities, or the big groups have very well developed R&D stations to have any sort of research on the broiler. So chicken meat transformation from feed to the meat is actually an art which is done with the management. And all these things make a broiler which is usually available in the market. Another important aspect which is usually very familiar in our country now, processed chicken, ready to cook, This is some sort of good scientific work, excellent farms with controlled house environment. Controlled house means ammonia, carbon dioxide, and other gases, and transfer of oxygen, ventilation, humidity, temperature, everything is controlled, monitored as per the need of the birds. And the management is much better, bio security and vaccination of the bird. That's usually the practice of the farms, but these people who process chicken, they get chicken from the very well-known sources, and usually they have their own houses kept well. So modern processing facilities are there. I don't name any one brand, there are certain 10 brand, 15 brand of Pakistan, all of you know well. But they have modern facilities, and their standard meets the requirement of the standards of the Gulf usually, and East Asia and South. Sometimes we are not now up to the standard of the Europe, but we have exports in Gulf, East Asia and South, in Hong Kong, in some other countries we had exported meat. And you know that's very high standard. Now chilled, frozen, graded, marinated, all meats are available. Quality assurance is safeguarded. A higher cost is much for a normal customer. The next is cooked national and international food chain chicken. Once again, I am not having one name. There are so many names, and you know all of them better. These are liked by maximum people, almost everyone. A sign of some rejoicing event. You go with the family and have a refreshment outside. Getting meat mostly from domestic food chain. They are getting mostly from the domestic food chains. It's not only chicken. It's much important because chicken may be one fourth of that burger, of that thing. Cold drinks, beverages, fries, high fat, singers, buns, etc. So you don't think that this is actually the chicken, but that's very tasty, very high cost item, affordable by limited population. Still much living activity for the needs of all of human mind. So it's some sort of parties, dine out, that is a specific form, but it's also available. Now, at how much time? I'll take some minutes. Problems in food chain. I mean food, if there is food, it has to be deteriorated, it's organic matter, and it must be processed and kept properly. So every food has some challenges, like wheat, it was if wheat grinded, that's actually wheat, but the flour we are getting, that's having some additions and some substitutions. Similarly, oil seeds are pure nutrition, canola, soybean, rapeseed, any sort of, but when we process that seed, there are some limitations. Fruits are very pure and natural sources, but spraying on the fruits and keeping quality of the vegetables and fruits, you know, that's a problem by man, not by the nature. Fish is also the best feed, you know, best food. Don't make it rancid while keeping, while transporting, while storage. So chicken is also a good diet and good food, but human factors create problems in that. What are their problems? Because transportation of the chicken from the farms, that's a proven step. And the chicken transporters may damage the legs, feathers, injuries, to just throw it inside the van. So exhausted birds in summer, heat stress conditions may be there. Weaker and affected birds, they may be started first. Spray sprinkle water increases weight of the bird, that's not nutritional loss, but yet another economic loss. Clean environment of the slaughtering, this is very problematic situation, because we see, so that's the real fact. Other things we don't see, this slaughtering we see. And the cross contamination there on the shore. And the hotel supply is also compromised, maybe, because this is the issue. I'm not jumping into the domain of the food authorities, but there's a big knock on hotel supply and the chicken available. But yet there are some scientific concerns. There will be not much rumors. Dr. Munawar, we have a presentation about the myths. But being a scientific student, as a colleague, the PSA World Poultry Science Association is attached here due to the scientific education and transfer of knowledge and the research. So we must accept that what are the facts and then proceed that what are the scientific areas where we can work. Antibiotic residues in the tissues, it's a big issue. And it's not basically coming from the feed sources, yet it's coming from other sources. Through the application of water soluble or water aerated antibiotics, cetaphil. In some other countries, there is a withdrawal period. In Pakistan, I can't say anything about that, but this is an issue. Microbial challenges like salmonella and other bacteria. This is also a problem, and it's a problem of cross-contamination because usually our food is cooked at a relatively higher temperature as compared to the international standards of whatsoever. But cross-contamination may be real, and these are the challenges of food sources and similar with the chicken. Viral problems like avian influenza and some other, usually this is not the fact of the industry. This is not the fact of the scientific fact, but you see the rumors. But let's see, we must have to have a glance on all these things. Cold chain maintenance in the storage, that is very much important for the processed chicken and processed chilled or frozen chains. Another important thing is taste, color, smell, and acceptability, all neuroleptic concerns. And this is what the normal person feels. That the taste of the chicken is deteriorating. So there must be studies along with this side because a mature chicken may have only best mature meat and due to aging of the bird. And some other issues, mycotoxin and the liver issues, also it could be addressed. So nutrient losses in processing and storage, it needs the scientific investigation and the studies, like, for example, I have just for example, I have taken TVBN values in the bad storage or good storage meat. So these tests do tell us the keeping quality of the meat, and they can tell also the aging of bad storage. And TVBN scoring is a typical test done for the storage. So to resolve all these issues, we need to research and study poultry science collaborated with food science and technology. That's why we are here. Chicken meat in the kitchen, it will be a long detailed subject, but I summarize it. That chicken, when it comes from the butcher's or the slaughter shop, it must be washed properly so that it may not contaminate. Cutting and size reduction before addition or in the freezer, that is much important. Grading and segregation, you know, and also the wrapper and the plastic things, they must be avoided. Because in storage, it's better that you don't keep a lot much time in the freezer zone. Cooking duration and temperature is also important. Addition of fats, spices, and salad vinegar. Later on we discuss it. And as I told, washing is very much important with hot water or hot with vinegar water. And use separate knife for cutting meat, as meat may, salads and other things, they may contaminate each other. Fast frying in oil, surface steaming, less time, overheating sometimes, leaves internal core of the meat not proper cooked. So chicken usually cooking, temperature maybe 160 to 180 degree Fahrenheit, if I'm not wrong, that's 75 degrees, 76 degree better for chicken. So the spices, they must also, in recipes, things added in the chicken, they must also be checked regarding their quality, their aflatoxin and other parts. There's a protein deficiency in the country. It's well documented, as Madam Shahina also told, Koshir Kaur and Nikhil Marasmus, stunting growth, 40 to 45% stunting growth in children, and malnutrition for 40.2 and 17.7, breastfeed 28.9, and then national nutrition survey 2018. So selection of the chicken is much important, because when we just keep this aspect to the seller, like potato, like anything, onions, anything else, they can give us anything which he wants. So we must be vigilant by the selection of the meat on the show. These are the some last take-home messages. Chicken is one of the best, fresh, low fat, high quality protein, essential amino acid source. Chicken meat is providing solutions to fulfill protein needs of the country as an economic source of nutrients. At farms and after farms, to chicken, to kitchen, sorry, a handling of meat can be improved by knowledge transfer and regulations. True knowledge about food can help us cooking best meat.